dissidence is vital to survival. What this world needs is more and more dissidents.
His name is Stetson Kennedy. He's an author and an activist, and he likes to say he's a founding member of Dissidents International.
Societies have managed over the eons to create institutions which conspire to discourage dissidents of all sorts, so that there are no self-correcting mechanisms in the society as a result. And instead of change for the better, you get static or decline.
Now in his 89th year, a time of life when most people are content to rest and reflect on the past, Kennedy remains active, writing and speaking, an advocate for reform and social change.
Newspapers with any sort of bias are apt to say, well, Kennedy's mellowed, the old firebrand is mellowed, and to which I say that my last words will be my most militant. So.
Born in Jacksonville in 1916, Kennedy became interested in the folk culture of Florida at an early age. He studied at the University of Florida and traveled abroad before landing a job collecting and recording folklore and oral history for the WPA Federal Writers Project. On Kennedy's team, Harlem Renaissance writer Zora Neale Hurston.
And I was in my early 20s, and Zora Neale Hurston, although she had published already a couple of novels, came on board as a junior interviewer, same title I had when I started, and the same pay, which was $37.50 every 2 weeks.
The project mission was described as holding up a mirror to Florida.
So when we came across some unpublished, unknown bit of information about the state and its people and cultures, we excited as kids on a treasure hunt.
Kennedy drew upon his WPA experiences for his first book, Palmetto Country, published in 1942. Still in print, it's considered one of the state's definitive folklore resources. Then in the mid-40s, he turned his attention to issues of social inequality. On a 1993 writers' panel, he described how becoming a civil rights crusader put him at odds with friends and family.
It was a matter of being internally exiled. And at a very tender age, I recall at table with my family, my sister said, "I do believe you'd rather be with them than with us." And I said, "As a matter of fact, I would." And got up from the table, and my family hasn't spoken to me, and it's been 40 or 50 years.
Kennedy began investigating the KKK, even attending Klan meetings under the name John Perkins, and sending reports to black newspapers in the North. But he was unable to find a publisher for books like The Klan Unmasked and Jim Crow Guide to the USA until moving to Europe in 1952.
The whole time I was overseas, I was doing my damnedest to give Uncle Sam a hot foot, a global hot foot, as I called it, on the question of race. And these books that I had not been able to get published in America, I found European and worldwide. Some of them went into a dozen different languages. Jean-Paul Sartre in Paris published my Jim Crow Guide.
Today, over 40 years later, Kennedy continues speaking and writing with the wisdom gained from a lifetime of reflection on the problems of injustice and civil rights.
Stetson finally is getting some of the recognition that he so deserves.
Peggy Bulger is director of the American Folklife Center at the Library of Congress in Washington, D.C.
He did a lot of work in the past and has continued to be an activist throughout his life. And I think that the work that he's done has not been recognized the way that it should be. And finally, now, he has been, if you will, rediscovered by many people.
The library's online collection of Florida materials includes recordings and photographs collected by Kennedy and Hurston in the 1930s. In spring 2005, Kennedy was selected for induction into the Florida Artists Hall of Fame. Secretary of State Glenda Hood.
You know, Stetson Kennedy has not only written about and told stories about the real heart and soul of Florida and Floridians, but, you know, I believe in many ways that he is the heart and soul of Florida. And we need to make sure that we not only recognize him for his great contributions, but we need to make sure that generations in the future are aware of what he has done. And no better way to do that than to have him as part of our Florida Artists Hall of Fame. And we thank Stetson Kennedy for everything that he has done.
These days, Kennedy still lives and writes in his small home in what was once a secluded location near the St. John's River south of Jacksonville.
Please welcome civil rights legend Stetson Kennedy.
He makes appearances around the state, such as at a recent event celebrating the music of his friend, Woody Guthrie.
My buddy Woody Guthrie used to say that a song that don't say something ain't worth nothing. And I've always felt the same way about all literature and the written and spoken words, that, that if there wasn't a content or a message, then I didn't have much time for it. Well, I have nothing against entertainment. And in my own case, I opted for trying to find solutions or paths out of the wilderness, so to speak. Yes, it was with a fond notion that if people knew, realized the extent of the injustice, and had any idea at all what they could do about it, that they would do it. I hope I'm right about that. Many signs, pro and con, remains to be seen.
I'm Bill Dudley. With funding from the Florida Department of State Division of Cultural Affairs, this report was produced by the Florida Humanities Council. Visit us on the web at flahum.org.